When COVID-19 hit the Esparza household, it was a domino effect that shook the New Jersey family to its core.
I woke up one day, fever. Then the next day, 2 days passed, my mother had a fever. 3 days after her, he had a fever. After him, it was like my brothers, my husband.
The family's patriarch, Ignacio, nearly lost his fight with the virus, but made a recovery that stunned even his doctors. Telling us he doesn't remember much of the ordeal and is just thankful to the doctors who treated him. The New Jersey family's battle with COVID-19 isn't an anomaly. They're part of a troubling trend nationwide where infection rates among Latinos and African Americans were 3 times higher than whites. The staggering federal data, which also shows communities of color are twice as likely to die from the virus than their white counterparts, is now the centerpiece of new legislation introduced by Senator Bob Menendez, the New Jersey senator who, along with Senator Ben Cardin of Maryland, the bill will focus on improving contact tracing, testing, and provide public awareness campaigns in minority communities around the country, something local leaders say has been lacking drastically in the current federal and state response.
We knew that people with underlying conditions and comorbidities were going to be hardest hit. We knew where those folks lived, and we didn't put any infrastructure for them to be tested.
Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams says while the bill is much needed, it needs to go farther.
We need to really look at what we did as a country, a city, and state, and determine if there were some clear civil rights violations, and if anyone intentionally did not ensure the right resources went to those communities of color.
The new legislation already has the support of a number of prominent Democrats, as well as several health groups. Now, if the bill does move forward, it's going to play a vital role in potential vaccine distributions, which will be tailored to those communities.